Rob Hollifield, you won the giveaway. Congratulations, comic fam. We're talking about the hottest comic books in the multiverse. What's good, comic fam? We're talking about the funny books that are caliente this week at the table virtually. Hit the subscribe, slap the like. We're shooting for 1,000 likes. Can we get there? Help us. Hit him with number 10, Jim.
What's going on, Comic Tom? I'd be happy to kick off this week's list. Coming in at number 10, we have Crime Suspense Stories, issue 17, with a cover so vulgar, so gruesome, you can kind of see why they had to come up with the Comics Code Authority.
A violent cover by Johnny Craig, a gentleman getting his muffin cap peeled back. Comic fam, we got some records to report on. A 4.5 back in February could have been secured for $456. It's up 97% this week, selling for $900.
That's right, man. Getting his top chopped off. We have a CGC 8.0, which sold for $942 back in 2019. It's up 91%, selling for $1,800.
We heard just last week, courtesy of Dinesh Shandasani, creator of Bad Idea, discussing his analysis on pre-code horror, just how much of a new emerging interest there is behind these particular genre of books, the violent covers, the covers that you couldn't imagine seeing hit the press at your LCS. It's taken the internet frenzy to renew this interest, regardless of how popular of a genre it's been for over a decade. Next, at the list, at number 9, this right here is some major spec. We have Bloodstone number 1.
We've talked about this book 3 times in the last 4 weeks. The first appearance of Elsa Bloodstone, and it's purely speculation that this may be the character that's written as Ruby in the upcoming Blade movie.
With Moon Knight, Blade, we're hearing rumors of Werewolf by Night slated. The occult, the supernatural is coming, and a powerful female lead is just what they're gonna need. Let's take a look at some of the money being spent on this key book. A 9.2 back in June could have been secured for $175. That's up 18%, selling for $206. The 9.6 could have been secured for $395 back in October. We saw that record broken twice this week. One sale of $431 and another, an increase of 21% since that October high of $479.
The CGC 9.8 sold for $900 back in October, and that record was broken twice this week. First, with an all-time high sale of $922, and now for a 6% increase, selling for $950.
Comic fam, if you like what we do, I mean, we've been doing this show for over a year straight without skipping a beat. You should hit the link in the description and join the mystery mail call. We're in active enrollment for the November box. Less than a week to join. One per box. Every member is getting a House of Slaughter number 1. Variant cover done by Davi Go. Virgins going out at random. And also one per box, Venom number 1. A variant done by the very talented Raph Grissetti. Join the community. And let's talk about number 8 on the list. We have some mischief to discuss. Loki's first appearance in Journey into Mystery 85.
Not only is it the first appearance of Loki, the third appearance of Thor, but it's the first cameo appearance of Odin and the first appearance of Heimdall. Last week, we saw the highest ungraded copy in a year's time, selling at $4,500.
We have a 1.0 back in December, could have been secured for $650. That's up 115% this week, blowing past the $1,000 marker, selling for $1,400. Then we had the 3.5 hitting its second highest sale since the record was set back in May of $4,350. The Loki hype was real. The show was in its prime, and we saw a $3,800 sale this past week. Although it's less, it's still trending upward, especially when you consider that 1.0 and this next 7.5 record breaker.
The 7.5 sold for $4,000 back in 2019, and it's up 197%, now selling for $11,889.
Considering that Loki Episode 6 concluded the season but confirmed a second season, it makes sense that there's still wind in these record-breaking sales. Next on the list, at number 7, Fantastic Four Annual 1, The Submariner spec is real.
That's right, we got Fantastic Four Annual 1. We have Namor on throne. In this issue, he finds the lost city of Atlantis. It's also the origin of the Fantastic Four retold, as well as the first appearance of Krang and Lady Dorma in the Silver Age. A CGC 3.5 sold for $335 back in May. It's up 28%, now selling for $428. The CGC 4.0 sold for $456 back in September, and that's up 16%, selling for $528.
The 4.5 could have been secured back in July for $540. That's up 7%. Steady gains with a new record leader of 579. This is a tough book to secure in high grade. Of course, it's the first annual, but it's a thick book, a classic Submariner cover, and it's these types of key appearances that we're seeing attention focused on. This isn't the only one that made the list. Let's keep it going. Stay tuned. Hit the subscribe button, and let's chat about Nova at number 6.
Yeah, the first appearance of Richard Rider, a key that's been primed for speculation ever since we had the Nova Corps show up in the Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 1.
We've known about Nova being slated for the MCU for over 4 years now. It's one of Kevin Feige's favorite characters, apparently. He brought this up on a podcast early January this year, doubling down on his statements that he said on the exact same podcast a year prior. We all got some deja brother voodoo that he had every intention to bring Sam Alexander and Richard Rider, both Novas, to the screen. We heard leaks last week that they will begin production in 2022 for a Nova movie. Will it happen? Well, it's all rumors. However, the books are selling and members are investing. We have a 5.5 back in August. Could have been secured for $92, up 9%, hitting 100 this week.
The CGC 7.5 sold for $170 back in October, and that's up 6%, now selling for $180.
Then we have the 9.8, selling in May for $2,470, still maintaining and increasing in sales, up 4%, selling for $2,575. Next at the list at number 5, Avengers number 3, the classic battle between the Avengers, the Hulk, and the Submariner.
A CGC 6.5 sold for $1,095 back in June. It's up 5%, selling for $1,150. A 7.5 sold for $809 in January, just primed for price correction, and it's up 42%, also selling for $1,150.
The 8.0 back in August could have been secured for $1,440. That's up 4% this week, selling for $1,500. We've already talked about Fantastic Four Annual 1 on this list. Avengers 3 is awesome, single-digit Kirby goodness. However, it's not a major key moment. I suspect members are starting to put money into affordable Submariner spec while they still can. We believe that he will appear in Wakanda Forever. He's going to debut in the MCU shortly, and we're going to show you just where members are starting to put their money, because it's not just these books.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of subby love on this list, and there are a lot of minor Submariner keys that have been gaining traction. Submariner number 5, the first appearance of Tiger Shark, saw a 236% increase in a CGC 8.5.
Submariner 50, the first appearance of Namor Reeda, earlier this month doubled in a 9.8 with a $3,360 record-breaking sale.
Fantastic Four issue 33, which was the first appearance of Atuma, had a previous high of $715 in September, and it sold for $1,000 this week.
Then we have Submariner number 8. This right here is a classic Buscema cover, Namor versus the Thing, selling for double its previous high at a 6.0 this past week.
And lastly, Tales to Astonish issue 100, which is a Hulk vs. Namor cover, sold for $195 in a CGC 8.0, coming in at $40 more than its previous high sale from June.
Do yourself a solid, comic fam. Utilize code TOM101 on the best comic book app for researching, learning, and cataloging your comic books. We're talking key collector comics available for both Androids and iPhones. Take a look at the search category, search characters, and put in Namor in the search bar. It's going to pull up all of these comics and so many more for you to consider. Keep up on your key books. And at the list at number 4, we're talking about some gods. Journey into Mystery Annual number 1.
Back on the list, the first appearance of Hercules, the first appearance of Thor, a double key, Thor Love and Thunder speculation.
It's true that these Olympians, the Norse gods, have appeared in timely and prior Marvel comics, but it wasn't until this issue where these particular versions of the characters would become a mainstay and carry on into further ongoing continuity. We know that the God Butcher will be introduced in this movie. What gods will be slayed? Well, we had a 9.8, the only one on the census, break records early February of this very year, prior record being set in 2003, the same issue for $6,075 and selling for $73,000 earlier this year. We knew price correction would come, and it's been arriving month over month.
A CGC 1.0 sold with no previous record, selling for $175.
The 3.5 could have been secured for $275 back in March. That's up 64% this week, selling for $450. I'll remind the comic fam that Russell Crowe broke the news earlier this year on a podcast, possibly letting it slip, that he was playing a character called Zeus in Thor 4.
Then we have the CGC 9.0, a book that sold for $2,400 back in March, up 60%, now selling for $3,840.
Hot damn, comic fam. Those are some gains at the list at number 3. Shuma-Gorath, Marvel premiere, issue number 10.
A character that seemingly wanted to be shown in Marvel's What Ifs in so many episodes, those tentacles coming out through portals, but we've yet to see Shuma-Gorath. The last time seen was in Marvel vs. Capcom 2, but collectors are speculating on the character. A CGC 7.0 sold for $123 back in February. It's up 208%, now selling for $379.
Shuma-Gorath is one of the most powerful entities in the multiverse. He's conquered universes. That means he's conquered a version of Thanos wielding the Infinity Gauntlet. That means nothing to him. He has conquered the embodiment of the universe, eternity. And if we see him in Multiverse of Madness, well, we're going to keep seeing prices for its book go up. An 8.0 could have been secured for $250 in March. We saw a $550 sale. We saw a $600 sale, an increase of 140%.
And half a bump up, we have an 8.5, which sold for $650 in June, up 15%, now selling for $749.
Some food for thought. We saw a 600% increase in copies sold for this comic book over the last week. This book made the trending list and then positioned itself at number 3 on this week's Hot 10. Holy smokes, that's a lot of gains. All because of a leak of a 1,000-piece puzzle for the Multiverse of Madness showing Shuma-Gorath on the front of it.
Now moving on to number 2, we have a key Spider-Man book, Amazing Spider-Man 101, the first appearance of Morbius, and I gotta be honest, I wasn't too thrilled on the Morbius movie until I saw this trailer before Eternals. It looked amazing.
Comic fam, for the first time in Hot 10 history, we are welcoming Amazing Spider-Man 101 to the Hot 10 list. We have the first appearance of the living vampire, Morbius, breaking all kinds of records. We have a 2.0 back in 2019 going for $227, up 32%, selling for $300. The 7.5 last week could have been secured for $1,350. Post-trailer up 11%, now selling for $1,500.
Then we have the 8.5, selling for $2,175 back in July, up 13%, now selling for $2,450. It looks like that trailer gave a lot of other people confidence as well.
It's certainly given me some confidence. I'm very hyped about this movie. Considering the 9.8 record leader was set early this year for under $13,000 and sales in the last 30 days have exceeded $20,000, I think the comic fam feels the same way. Hit the subscribe, slap the like button, help us get to 1,000 likes. Can we get there? It'll enter you to win a Boys Comic Tom Gem Mint exclusive Ben Templesmith Virgin variant. And Jem, hit him with the number 1 hottest comic book in the multiverse.
And guys, spoiler alert for the Eternals. If you guys haven't seen the Eternals and you don't want to get spoiled, you might have to skip the number 1 book in the comic book market right now. But you've been warned. Here it goes. Strange Tales 179, the first appearance of Pip the Troll.
We knew back in March, if you were following Key Collector Comics, that Pip the Troll was rumored for the Eternals. We got rumors of Eros weeks before the release. We got rumors of Pip the Troll, but confirmation this week that our marshmallow hiding troll under his loincloth is now here to stay in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. We have some record breakers to discuss. An ungraded copy sold for $185 back in May. That's up 16% this week, selling for $215.
A CGC 9.0, which sold for $185 back in May, is up 86%, selling for $345.
And then the 9.6. The all-time record was surpassed not one, not two, but three times this week. Prior record set in September for 737, up 15% with a new leading high of $850. Comic fam, have a great week. And as always,
geek responsibly and stay minty fresh.
Enough said. Comic fam, you know what's going on every single Wednesday. It's Whatnot Wednesday, the best new place to buy and sell comic books, collectibles. We pack the house with so many amazing dealers and sellers, and we're adding another.
That's right, baby. I'm going to be kicking off Whatnot Wednesdays coming in at 2 p.m. Pacific. That's 5 p.m. Eastern with my first live action comic book sale on Whatnot. I did a live auction preview on my channel last Sunday. I did one on Instagram. I got some great books lined up, and I'm excited to join the team here.
Link in the description. Follow both of our pages, and we'll see you Wednesday.